Foreign Motion, I'm Kurt Parker. If you're from central or western Pennsylvania, come late January, your thoughts turn to concerns regarding the hibernation habits of a certain individual. For decades, many have descended upon the small town of Punxsutawney, Pennsylvania, to visit the prognosticator of prognosticators, Punxsutawney Phil. Most know the lore. If he comes out of his burrow and sees a shadow, 6 more weeks of winter there will be. Whether you believe that as fact or fiction, the groundhog is a mysterious rodent that poses some very interesting questions, at least to one researcher all the way on the other side of the state.
They're about as accurate as our weather people.
Stam Zervanos is a professor emeritus of biology at Penn State Berks, and while most are concerned with the groundhog's weather forecasting abilities, Dr. Zervanos is interested in the possible benefits to mankind that understanding what happens during hibernation would bring.
The question that we're looking at in our study is what we call Darwinian fitness, which basically involves the mating process, how you get your genes into the next generation. And hibernation is part of that. In other words, hibernation involves survival over the winter. And those that can do it the best are the ones that are going to be able to reproduce the next spring.
Dr. Zervanos operates a lab on the Berks campus. It's a 140-acre plot on the Pfeiffer farm. And with multitudes of groundhogs on hand, he has a great opportunity to study the rodents up close.
In that 140 acres, there's probably 80 or so groundhogs. So it's an ideal area to study these animals. We have a shed where we keep our equipment in and are able to monitor the animals at a distance using radio telemetry. We are able to get from radio telemetry their body temperatures throughout the year, and also particularly during the winter, but also we're able to get heart rate and location to some extent.
Groundhogs have regular hibernation patterns that begin and end about the same time every year. When the hibernation season is over, groundhogs quickly begin to improve their chances for survival.
They're not coming out to predict the weather. What they're trying to do is find out where their mates are. And the females know that there are males in their territory. And as soon as they come out of final hibernation, they really don't stop hibernating until the first week in March. And this is a fitness value to it, because they only have a short period of time to mate in order for the young to be born early enough so that the young can grow by the end of the summer to be large enough to hibernate.
After determining the hibernation routines of his subjects, Dr. Zervanos sought to find out whether location plays a part in the rodent's states of arousal and torpor.
We're going to collect animals from our 3 study sites. One is in Maine, University of Southern Maine. The one's here, right here at this campus. And then the third one is at Clemson University. And what we'd like to see is, do they carry the characteristics of hibernation from the location they came from under a constant environment where they're all the same, what we call a common garden experiment. There is a theory out there that all mammals were able to hibernate way back in their ancestry, since we evolved from reptilian ancestors, which were able to hibernate. There would seem to be, the logic would seem to say that all mammals have those genes, or at least the genes that can turn on and off the metabolic processes that affect hibernation. If we can track down those controlling genes, then we might be able to apply the characteristics of hibernation, let's say, to humans. When a hibernator, such as a groundhog, goes into hibernation, it rolls itself up and stays that way, basically for long periods of time, yet they're able to come out of their burrows at full strength and be able to avoid predators and mate and things like that.
And John Griffiths,
After so the next time February 2nd rolls around and multitudes are waiting to see if Punxsutawney Phil can predict the future, just remember that the larger benefit of the animal may not come from what he does when he wakes up, but what goes on while he quietly sleeps. For In Motion, I'm Kurt Parker.